So in this lecture we will try to cover the energies of the particle. So this video particularly I am shooting in English, so please tell whether English is good or Hindi was best. So let's begin. So we have to find now energies. So what are energies basically? Which type of energies are there? So there are two types of energy, kinetic and potential energy. So what is kinetic energy normally? So normal kinetic energy, which we are which formula we are using since 10th standard, is half mv square. Okay, so half is a constant, m is a mass, and v is the velocity of the particle performing SHM. So we already know what is v. We have derived earlier in this chapter, v is plus minus omega root of a square minus x square. So this is my v. So what will be v square? So v square will be square of anything is positive. So negative sign will vanish and it will become omega square. Root will also go cancel because square and root will cancel out each other. So what will be left over is this term. So now I can substitute this v square in these values. So what I will get is half m. Now v square is basically omega square and a bracket inside bracket a square minus x square. So this is the formula for the kinetic energy, but it is little bit inappropriate because see, I have relation k by m is equals to omega square, and if m goes here, so I will get k is equals to the m omega square. So why not substitute k instead of this? So let us substitute k. So I will get half k a square minus x square, and that is my final equation for the kinetic energy. So it is actually difficult to remember the formulas for kinetic energy, potential energy, as well as the total energy. So I suggest to remember the derivation method. It will take just 10 to 20 seconds to write this formula and substitute this value. So this is my final formula for kinetic energy. Now let us come to potential energy. So what is potential energy basically? What it actually means? So potential means the energy which is already present inside the particle and because of which particle is able to move. See, if I want to move, I have some energy inside me, then I am using that energy to move. So that is my potential energy. So same way, potential energy is basically the work which particle has done, because suppose this much is energy, so this much work can be done. Just a case of example, suppose this much is energy, so work done will be also this much. This was just to explain. Okay, so let us substitute the formula. So what do we know? That work done is equals to the force into displacement. So here work done is, say, small work is done. A particle is moved from this point to this point. A small amount of work is done. Displacement is also very small, and we know work is directly proportional to displacement. F is directly proportional to x, and F is equals to the minus kx because directions are different. Therefore, here I include the minus sign also. Now I know forces, F is equals to the minus kx. So I will substitute minus kx here. So minus minus will become plus. So I will left over with kx dx. So here I have dw, here I have dx. So on both the sides, I have terms of d. So I can safely integrate this above equation. So integrating above equation. So what I will get is integration of dw is equivalent to integration of kx dx. So what is this integration basically? So x dx means, so dx is a small element or a small displacement. Say this displacement is dx. Okay, so when I integrate this, this means taking this times, integration means summing up. Summing up, can I can say that adding up all the small parts. So suppose there are small parts dx, and I am integrating, then means I am adding all the above parts which are dx. So what will be my initial and final point? So initial point will be this when x is equals to the 0, and final point will be x is basically x. It has reached the destination. So dw, there is nothing w, integration of dx is x. So same way dw integration will be w. K is a constant, k will come outside, and here I will left over with x. So integration of x basically will be x square, that 2 by 2. So here is my kx square by 2. So I can write this better as half kx square. Okay. So half kx square. Now I already know that k is equals to the m omega square. So if I want the equation in these terms, then it is better, because kinetic energy equation I have also written in this form. I can also use that form also. I can re-substitute them as half m omega square x square. So in exam it can come in this way, it can come in this way. So it's your choice. So finally I have derived the formulas for kinetic and potential energy. So I will rub every part except the two energies, so that I can be able to find the total energy of the system, the total energy of the particle. So this is my kinetic energy Ke, which is equals to half Ka square minus x square. My potential energy is equal to half Kx square. So what will be total energy? So total energy is always equals to kinetic energy plus potential energy. So simply I have to add. So this is total energy, which is equals to kinetic energy plus potential energy. So kinetic energy is equals to the half k a square minus x square plus potential energy half k x square. So half k x square. I can take out half k common from both the sides, from both the terms I should say. So half k, if it is common, then here I am left over with a square minus x square plus x square. So here I can see both the terms are getting cancelled. So I get half k a square as my total energy. So here I can now write the third formula for energy of a particle performing SHM, which is half k a square. So basically it's very easy to derive all these formulas, but it's fine. So here are the three formulas. In the next video we will see how the energy gets conserved in SHM at the main position and at the extreme position. So see you soon in my next video. Share this video as much as possible and tell me English was better or Hindi is better. Hindi was better or English is better.